Well, it seems like the safest place to play in the surf, shallow water, but every summer, swimmers suffer serious neck injuries close to shore.
It's a challenge to rescue that injured person or persons without causing even more damage. 11 News' Kerry Cavanaugh traveled to Ocean City to see how the Beach Patrol is saving lives with its unique technique.
Ocean City's 10.5 miles of sandy beaches offer a place to relax, soak up the sun, and catch a wave. Body surfers and boogie boarders slip in and out of the surf, but sometimes the waves can be punishing, breaking in a way that results in serious injury, even death.
It was pretty ironic that I almost died 20 feet from shore in about 3 feet of water, about that much water, being that I was a rescue swimmer for the U.S. Secret Service.
52-year-old Kelly Ward says he found himself defenseless against a large wave while body surfing near 110th Street in July 2008. We spoke to him shortly after his accident.
What I remember about it is catching the wave, and then it took me up to the top of it, and I was probably 6 feet in the air, and it just broke, and I did a missile nosedive.
The wave slammed Ward head first into less than 3 feet of water. Lifeguard John Clouser saw it all from his stand. He rushed into the waves and rolled Ward over.
He looked dead. His face was purple. His eyes were rolled back in his head.
Clouser suspected a spinal cord injury and needed to get Ward out of the water without causing more damage.
Rather than take the time to get a backboard to the person, our personnel become a human backboard.
The Ocean City Beach Patrol has been recognized for perfecting a rescue technique called in-water spinal immobilization. The idea is to protect the spinal cord by immobilizing the person's upper body in the water. The guards agreed to demonstrate it for us while 11 News cameras rolled in the water on the beach and up above from Sky Team 11. Below, a lifeguard named Jake plays the role of a victim who suffers a neck injury and goes limp. The first guard to spot Jake whistles for help and runs into the water. He rolls Jake face up and threads his arm under Jake's to brace the victim's head against his chest. He locks it into place with his arms. A second guard responds. He lifts the victim's knees. Seconds later, two more guards dive in to help carry the victim out of the water. Together, all four try to keep the victim's spine aligned, all while dodging waves. You can see how physically demanding it is. That first responder has not moved his arms. They're still locked in place on either side of Jake's head.
All right, one dry sand.
All right,
set his legs down.
Again, they're careful to keep the spine aligned as they lay the victim down and use a modified CPR position that does not move the head or neck. Once the victim is breathing,
one, two, three.
He's transferred to a backboard. Beach Patrol Captain Butch Arbin drills every guard on the technique.
They basically maintain one solid unit, so that person's upper body is not allowed to move. That works as well as a backboard. In fact, when you have somebody strapped to a backboard, they don't feel any more secure strapped to a backboard than when one of our people have them in that maneuver.
The Beach Patrol says the most dangerous time to ride the waves is during shore break, a condition that usually occurs at high tide. Instead of the waves breaking out in deep water, which is safer for body surfers and boogie boarders, during shore break, the waves continue to build as they approach the shore. Those large waves eventually break on a shallow, sandy incline, putting you at greater risk for neck and spinal injuries.
The Beach Patrol says a single wave can pack 2,000 pounds of force. And when it slams you headfirst into the shore, this wet packed sand can feel just as hard as concrete.
Captain Arvin says the best way to protect yourself is to swim only when lifeguards are on duty. Ask the guards if shore break is a concern and keep some body surfing safety tips in mind.
How much protection do you have if you do this when you body surf?
Well, what happens if you do this? Chances are you're going to absorb most of the blow on your arms. You might get a dislocated shoulder, you might get a broken collarbone, but that's far better than a neck injury.
As for Kelly Ward, he was flown to shock trauma for emergency surgery. Neurosurgeon David Gens credits the Beach Patrol with saving Ward's life.
They did an excellent job, and now that was life or death. This is why it's so important to understand spinal immobilization and just not dragging someone out of the water and throwing them on the beach.
Nearly a year later, Ward is walking again and eager to get back in the ocean, even if he's given up body surfing.
It's the toughest 11 months of my life.
And he knows how fortunate he is that the Beach Patrol knew how to handle his injury.
They saved my life.
In Ocean City, Kerry Cavanaugh, WBAL-TV 11 News.